You want to see the Mario poster before you end stream? Put it in the community tab. We're going to look at it right now in the community tab. Sorry, guys, for the short stream today. I wish it could have been longer, but I got cooked. You said an art dump? Wolfenstein? Hey, the Opie looking kind of nice. Kirby falls with different screams. Was that Hungry Box? That sound like Hungry Box. I don't know why. The Tyler 1 scream. What the fuck, dude? This is the Mario poster? Tune in on the 6th for Nintendo Direct, the Super Mario Bros. Movie presentation. The world premiere trailer for the upcoming film. No game information will be featured. This shit definitely about to get leaked. There's gotta be some references in here. What is this, Captain Toad? These are like Captain Toad worlds up here. I see where all these pipes go. All these different color pipes. Yo, you see the stitching in Mario's hat. This is Captain Toad.
Mario, let me show you. Let me show you around the Mushroom Kingdom.
They selling POW blocks and P switches. Did you spot the minion yet? There's a minion? Where at? There's a cheap in a freaking bag. That motherfucker's not breathing in there. You said Mario don't got an ass. Bro, what? Yo. Is people out here really looking to see Mario caked up, like, double jiggly butt cheeks? Like, what is wrong with y'all? Mario's not going to be caked up in that way. You know damn well, like, Miyamoto, he ain't going to want that. Miyamoto is not going to want that. He's going to be pissed off. Okay. Sam O'Neill came back. Who is Sam O'Neill? I don't know who that is. I feel bad for Jeffrey Dahmer. TikTok is weird.
This nigga was going around killing gay men, specifically gay black men, throughout the 90s, right? In the late 80s, early 90s in Milwaukee. The reason why he was doing it, because he's a fucking sick nigga. Now, people say that he might be because he's racist, but I don't really think it's that. It's just that he was in a low-income environment, and every single time people would complain about him, this nigga, like, nobody would do anything because he was white and they were black, and it was, like, the peak of the HIV crisis with, like, Magic Johnson and shit like that. People didn't know what was going on. So if you were gay, they were like, oh, this nigga might have HIV, so I'm not about to go deal with this nigga at all because I might catch it. Then also, not only did he kill them, he would, like, literally, like, make them, like, zombies. He would drill a hole in the back of their neck and put acid in there, reflect some things. Then after he would, like, let them, like, die for a second, he would then put their bones in acid to scrape off all the bones and shit, like the cartilage off the bone, and save the bones and remaining. People would complain about the stench because he would just keep human body and flesh in his apartment, and they could smell it all throughout the apartment complex. Usually a lot of crazy shit, bro. Like, a lot of crazy shit. And then, like, he would get off. He would have an erotic fetish with, like, touching human flesh and playing with people's hearts and shit like that. Yeah, the nigga was nasty. I'm not joking either.
Mouth open the whole time. That's me.
black people to the... And they said it's only 17, only, but some people feel like it's probably way more. In one of the episodes, he was kind of in a semi-relationship with this deaf black guy who was also gay. And, like, people felt like he was just, like preying on some of the weakest links in in the community. He also did it to kids as well. Like, he did it to a 14-year-old. Yeah, and it was sick. So Netflix dropped a documentary on Jeffrey Dahmer. And a lot of people have had some mixed feelings about him, unfortunately. You would think, especially with his face looking the way it is right now, that people would have a complete disgust and disdain for Jeffrey Dahmer. But for whatever reason, this is...
Yo!
What?
Nigga, I thought Dexter was the limit. You watch the show Dexter?
No, it's...
He would cut please, Dexter isn't even the surface, bro. I know what show he's talking about. I mean, I've only watched a little bit of Dexter. I never fully finished it, but from what I understood, he was like a murderer, but he also worked inside of the police academy, and I think he was like in the forensics department. But he is from so far what he said, he is nowhere near Dexter shit.
Human bodies and shit?
Much worse.
And that was like his passion?
Yeah, no.
I'm like, that's the peak of like fucking insanity.
He used to eat him too.
Yeah.
Jeffrey Dahmer used to eat him.
Eat them?
He used to cook them and eat them, too.
Cannibalism?
No, but it's actually very real.
I know, that's
like, crazy. They had, like, all the bones of people in there. He used to take pictures of them, too. He took pictures, that's the other thing I meant to tell you. He took pictures of them and kept them. And so he just had them in a drawer. If any point the police just went near to search his shit, they would have found him easily. But they never went inside of his apartment complex. The reason why he got caught...
Because he a white dude.
...is because one of the... He was a black dude who, he ran around naked and stopped in front of police with handcuffs, and that's how they finally got him, because one of his victims was able to get away. So that is who Jeffrey Dahmer is. So you, and mind you, this is a 10-part documentary, and a lot of which are telling some of the stories of some of his victims as well. You would assume that finally when he died in episode 10, that you'd be like, oh my goodness, this is a great thing.
Stopped. This is great. Fuck that guy. He died. You telling me that there's people out there sympathizing with it?
That's right. As you would think, right? When he finally died, Somebody killed him, you'd be like, goodness, he's done.
Yes, thank God.
Yeah, thank God.
He's dead.
He's done.
I wish worse happened.
But what ended up happening is that people are now having sympathy for him.
People are weird.
No.
They made a fan cam for him. Yo, people on the internet, I'm sorry. I'm going to say some fucked up shit. If you are a sympathizer for this man, anything that happens to you in life that's even remotely unfortunate, you deserve it. And yo, if you sympathize with this guy and something bad happens to you, you deserve it 100%. You could be like, yo, a family member passed away. Smoking that bozo pack, bitch, because good for you, because you sympathizing with these psychopaths.
Check it out, check it out. I'm not watching a TikTok edit of a serial killer. What? I'm not watching it.
What?
That's, you make those for, like, soccer players.
No. Yeah.
No, you make those for, like, entertainers or, like, your family. Like, for someone that you could love, you could potentially, like, oh, I like that guy.
No.
Yo, a serial killer...
Come on, bro. Stop. Look at his physique.
Not
bro.
Even good form, neither.
Bro, just look at his physique.
Come on, we're good. We're gonna celebrate.
Serious question. Is there something wrong with me because I hike?
Yes. There is something wrong with you. 100% there is something wrong with you. And she has the horny face. You're horny for a serial killer. You're fucking weird, bro. You're fucking weird.
He felt bad for Jeffrey Dahmer. Okay, so first things first, that whole documentary was like 12 out of 10. Like, that shit was fire. Coming from someone that likes like true crime shit, right? Now, throughout
there's an epidemic of people, primarily women, watching these true crime episodes, and it is influencing the way they see life to the point where they're coming out with really, really bad takes on things.
Yes, they are. And then they're also being, for some reason, they're also being, like they're being turned on by the evil, right? Like, that's literally how they are. They're literally like what Sora Indigo is saying. Now, hear me out. That's literally what they're doing. Now, hear me out. I'm not saying I wouldn't fuck him, but I would fuck him. And I'm just like, huh? What's going on?
You saying something is fire after watching people lose their lives, like, man, that shit was so cold, dog.
Yeah, that's weird. How do you say that after watching a documentary? Like, if I saw a documentary on this shit, I probably would have been like, my God, this was insane.
These women graduated high school and are still into the bad boys trope.
Bro, no. That's not even a bad boy. This man is a killer.
If you're talking to a woman and her favorite thing to watch is true crime,
that's red flag.
Red flag. Run.
Red flag. If you talk to a girl and her favorite shit is true crime, run.
You tell a girl you red watch flag. True crime channel, she'll be all over you. They want to be the I can fix him type so bad.
Yes, they want to be the I can fix him type. I don't understand why, though.
Oh, man, that shit was entertaining as fuck, man.
After I was done with that, I'm in so serious chat. I had watched it for like, after episode 5 or 6, whatever episode that was with the death man, I had to like take a day break. I was like, I can't. I had to like pause for a second. This is a lot. I had to chill out for a second, bro. Y'all speed running through a Jeffrey Dahmer series is
true. You know what? I might have to watch this shit just so I could give my input. But yeah, these girls, they be speed running these series and then they start drawing fucking fan art, making fan cams. They probably write fanfics about this shit.
I walked up to Jeffrey Dahmer and right when he was gonna kill me, my nipples puckered.
Like, sir, speed up the vid. Who the fuck is this guy? Dune Glider? Hold on. Speed up the video. Chat, should I kill him? Chat, should I kill him?
It's crazy, bro. Yeah. Y'all binge watching this in 1 or 2 days. Y'all are crazy, bro.
Nah, this is.
I had to stop for a second. I was like, yeah.
I want to hear her reason why, though.
Thing, I was like, damn, like, this shit is crazy. Like, that's so sad. All, like, the murders and everything that, like, he did. The way he did it, like, I was like, damn, like, this shit is mad scary. Like, that's so sad. But I was, like, fine throughout the whole thing because, like, I watch a lot of true crime, whatever. But, bitch, when they killed Jeffrey, I was, like, literally teary-eyed. Like,
she sound like a New Yorker, too, bro. She from New York. She from New York 100%. She a New Yorker. This is why I gotta get the fuck out of here. She's from New York, because the way she's talking, she's saying the word mad. This shit is mad scary, son. Like, oh my God. Like, I was dead ass just crying right now. Like, I was looking at this man legit just get killed, and I'm just like, I am bugging the fuck out. New York. Bro, she weird.
I got teary-eyed. I'm looking at my...
Turn this shit off, nigga. Turn that off. You're fucking weird.
Facts.
There's no way you just said the murders, whatever. The murders.
It was so sad.
It was so sad. But the murders, whatever, were so sad. But when the actual serial killer lost his life, oh my God, I couldn't take it.
Oh. Yeah, nah, this is not real life.
No, yeah, you're... You're odd. And you know what's so crazy? I came in this thinking I was going to be a little neutral, right? What are you doing?
We're awake, right?
You saw his eyes? Hell yeah. Look at... He was recalibrating his mind. My man was recalibrating.
Thinking I was going to be a little neutral, right? What are you doing?
We're awake, right?
I came into this trying to be
straight recalibrating.
Because, to be fair, the way that it's written, it is written in a way in almost like you come across as sympathetic, or at least it makes the story. It's a very well put together story, right? But I wasn't crying when this nigga died. It's not like you weren't even crying for the other 17 people you watched die.
Bro, do we live in a simulation?
Like, oh my God, like, please don't tell me they kill him. Don't tell me he died. I'm looking at myself like, bitch, what? Like, what? For some reason, like, everything that he did that was, like, absolutely horrifying, just, like, out the window. I'm literally, like, looking to my side and I'm like, please tell me they don't kill him. I felt so fucking bad. Like, I actually felt bad. Like, it was, like, ridiculous. I'm thinking to myself, like, you should not be feeling bad for this man. Like, but I deadass didn't want him to die. Like, I was kind of pissed. I was like, what the fuck?
I ain't gonna lie, this is actually worse than I thought, bro. You're sexualizing this man.
Is that him?
Yeah, that's it's him washing his hands after it's him killing someone.
Blood off of his hands. That's what that was in the beginning. That shit he put in a cup is him drugging his next victim. Y'all niggas is sick, bro. I actually didn't know it was like this. This is actually very weird.
Isn't that important to have like a anti opinion? Like, can we all agree?
Bro,
we
I ain't gonna lie.
All be able to agree.
Bro, I ain't gonna lie. I did not think it was this bad. I thought y'all were gonna like just say the character in the story was well written. And you have a bit more understanding for him, but like, nah, y'all sexualizing this man in the act of killing people.
I need to know what the psychology is.
If these type of girls watch JoJo Part 5, they probably feel bad for the main antagonist because of they probably fell in love with his appearance.
He gets murdered in prison, and he's like really silent, and he just like gets battered to a pulp. Like, I totally appreciate. This man is probably, like, the worst of the worst. No, he is the worst of the worst. He is literally, like, Lucifer himself. Like, it's that bad. He's a cannibal. He's a sexual predator. He drugs people. He beats them. He dismembers them. He murders them. He tortures them. He eats them. Like, he keeps their body parts. Like, he is crazy. This man is crazy. But for some reason, I feel really sorry for him. Like, oh, my God. But in my heart, I'm like, I feel really sorry for you. I feel really sorry that you are that lonely.
Also, he wasn't lonely.
He wasn't lonely. You know why? Because he was with all the dead bodies. So technically, he wasn't lonely. Second, the fact that you're even sympathizing or feeling lonely or feeling bad for said character makes no sense. He is the bad guy. That's like me seeing Bowser kidnap Peach the whole time, and I'm that one dumbass on the sidelines that's like, damn, bro, why can't you just give Bowser Peach, bro? Let him pipe once. Come on, why don't you just let Bowser win? Yeah, he an asshole. Yeah, he got a bunch of henchmen, but who cares? Let him pipe the queen. Let him pipe Princess Peach.
Bro, what in the fuck? Where he was literally in an ongoing relationship with in one of those episodes. He was not lonely. He was surrounded with several men all the time. He was not lonely. But the fact that y'all get... But this is the... And people think that this is the reason why they should not make series of, like, serial killers. Because it forces people... People cannot discern mentally. They cannot contextualize mentally. They do not have the emotional...
capacity,
intelligence to sit here and to acknowledge their feelings about something does not usurp the actual facts of it, or they walk away with something, especially when you make a serial killer the main character. You kind of like push aside the 17 other bodies and make them less significant than the actual person at the top, like who's actually killing them. What makes it worse is that in the series, here's what's crazy.
And I'm not gonna lie though, too. I might watch the show myself just so I could get the full picture. But best believe, I would not be surprised if the show itself, the way that they directed it...
Whoa.
I would not be surprised if the show, the way that they directed it, they made you feel sympathetic for the character. Because sometimes, maybe the girls are at fault, but maybe I have to watch it myself to see how the director narrated the story. Because I wouldn't be surprised if I'm watching the show and then they literally made you feel bad for the character in terms of music, cinematography, all that type of dog shit. You say, honestly, I agree that they shouldn't make series about these killers in some way. They are almost glorified. I was just going to say that as well. Yeah, they kind of glorify them. And they did, when in reality, we should be clowning these motherfuckers for doing these. But then you know what's crazy? It's the girls out here that's all out here then swooning over him. And I'm just like, bro, y'all fucking weird. Like, y'all don't know what y'all want. Y'all don't know what y'all want.
Crazier. In the last two or three episodes of the series, when they finally caught Jeffrey Dahmer and put him in jail, bro, he was receiving love letters in jail. people got his story and they just start writing to him like, oh my God, I love you so much. Can you sign me an autograph and send it back? They were sending him money in jail, all that.
I don't even know what to say.
I'll be honest with y'all. This is actually much worse than what I thought it was. I did not know that there's people who are being to this level of sympathetic and y'all making compilations of what this man was doing in the act. Bro, what is this? Anyone else secretly thinking Jeffrey Dahmer was hot? Nah.
When everyone is freaking out about how morbid the new Dahmer show is, and you're just...
You got earrings of him? You're fucking weird. You're fucking weird, bro. If I see anyone outside with a Jeffrey Dahmer earring, t-shirt, and in any way, shape, or form, they're glorifying him, I'm gonna say something. I'm gonna be like, oh, you're fucking weird for wearing that shirt. You're a fucking weirdo. What the fuck, dude?
You're just bummed they didn't show the actual morbid parts.
Bro, these are people who really lost their lives. They're real victims. It's something that is very serious. You all, like, overlooking the fact that 17 people died in that documentary, and some of you all are obsessing and sexualizing a serial killer, or the fact that you are looking at families are actually affected by this, and y'all take away from it was, man, I just feel so sorry for Jeffrey Dahmer.
It's honestly crazy. Not surprised. It's these types that, like, of psychopaths things, usually have adult, a weird charisma. Charles Manson also has a cult of weird-ass girls trying to get into his pants. Some people is just weird, SMA.
Even as adults, like, y'all niggas are not really thoroughly prepared yet to really be watching shit like this. Because if you are...
No, I agree. He said something very important. He said there's a lot of adults out here that are not mentally prepared to even be viewing these types of shows. That also goes with the show Euphoria. I remember when the show Euphoria came out, right? There were mad fucking kids watching that show. Kids definitely weren't supposed to be watching that show, but they were watching that show. In Euphoria, there was this one guy, I keep forgetting his name, it was the football player. This man literally was abusing his girl, like grabbing her by the face type shit, grabbing her by the neck, leaving marks, and people were doing the same thing on TikTok. They were glorifying him. They were like, oh, I wish he could grab me like that. Huh? Huh? People are weird.
Only compassionate, or you were more compassionate about Jeffrey Dahmer than the actual victims, to the point where you cried when he died instead of like the actual victims.
You said the problem is these shows are being targeted towards teenagers. Not necessarily. I mean, there's teenagers in a teenage environment, but the show is not necessarily, I guess, marketed towards them, because off rip is like crazy shit is happening off of episode one. It's a lot of trauma. But the weird part is that the problem that I feel like is that it's easy to watch the show. It's not that hard to watch these rated R shows. That's what it is. It's very easy and it's very like accessible to watch all these things that you're not supposed to be seeing. It's like the same thing with pornography. I know we're like completely going off on a tangent, but back in the day, watching shows like that was way harder to do because you actually had to like own the channels. The internet wasn't around, all that extra stuff. But now that we have cell phones, it is so much easier to just view anything. Very, very easy to view anything that you're technically not supposed to be viewing. Like right now with my iPhone, I type down four letters, I'm seeing naked tits in HD and dicks everywhere. And it's the sad, scary reality of life. It is what it is. It is what it is, man. But it's just stupid how people then, like, just glorify this shit.
Something is severely wrong with you. And you going to TikTok and asking, man, what is the... I'm just wondering about all my psychiatrist viewers out there. What is it? What is the thing called when I feel sorry for the serial killer but not the other people who died? What is that called?
Being weird. Just
go talk to somebody, nigga. Go see somebody. Because you clearly are off mentally. Something's wrong with you. But yeah, I think it's very odd that, like, y'all found that as entertainment. Like, him... chopping up people, 17 people died. Y'all just like, oh, that's entertainment. But then y'all were like really just harped on your strings when he died. Like, that's what he's like, oh my goodness. Hey man, let us.
I don't know what the takeaway is from this.
I'll be honest with you. That's what I'm about to say. I don't know what the takeaway is, this, man. Hey, we talked a lot about this. We cannot upload it, so make sure you click the membership link below, man. Also, let us know y'all thoughts. And if you fall under the umbrella with some of these crazy people.
Yeah, the only thing I guess I could say is you need Jesus. What does the comment say?
This nigga was going around killing.
What does the comment say? I don't care who you are. Defending a serial killer is insane. Go seek help. Facts. Bro, the families of the victims must be losing their shit seeing all of this madness. True. My problem is the fact that nobody is actually addressing how much of a role the Milwaukee Police Department played in all of it. Straight mishandling of the situation. And on top of that, two cops got their jobs back and one of them became president of the police union. That's crazy. That's crazy how in reality during the 70s and the 90s with the very prolific serial killing rundowns, there really were females that fangirled over them and romanticized them. Fucking weirdos. You can feel bad about his backstory and his childhood, but my and everybody else's sympathy should end for the guy as soon as he kills somebody. People needs to care more about the victims than the killer. I'm surprised so many people haven't heard the story of, yeah, I haven't even heard the story. This is the first time I heard the story about it, to be honest, but I'm super obsessed with watching documentaries and shows about serial killers. The Netflix show was probably the best depiction of the story because you actually got to see the other side, the family stories. Most shows don't talk about the families at all. I never felt bad for him. Very happy he was murdered in jail, even though I do understand forgiveness. Bro, there is no realm of forgiveness if you killed that many people and you ate them. There is no realm of forgiveness. Like the fact to even bring up the option of forgiveness. Like, Nick, like, ooh, I'm about to bug out. Like, my inner New York. I was about to say the N-word, bro. My inner New York is about to come out, bro. Oh, bro. How can you even sympathize, bro? Let it loose? Bro, my inner New York was about to come out, bro. Y'all saw it? Yo, and mind you, you know I have, like, good control over it. And my inner New York was about to burst out. The fact that you even act like this is fucking Undertale and there's a mercy tab for him. Like, this is how I'm looking at it. People are looking at this guy like he has a mercy tab at the bottom right. No, there is no mercy for him. It's just straight death. Listen to some anime cute songs, chill a bit. The mercy tab, bro, remember when Asgore destroyed the mercy tab and it's just fight, items, and talk or whatever? There is no mercy tab. Like, it's so dumb. Like, it's just like me reading these comments, I'm starting to understand. I'm just like, bro, people are dumb, dude. Even though I do understand forgiveness, I also believe in karma. I honestly think that these Gen Z girls are only romanticizing him because they want to seem edgy and they heard that's what other women did at the time. If he was alive, they would shut the fuck up. The average IQ of America will rise if TikTok is deleted. True. Them making, okay, this is too long, okay, them making a drama story into a dramatized form of media was the worst thing that they could have done. Now you have people romanticizing and making memes about a serial killer who got away with his crimes due to an adequate system based on racism and homophobia, which ultimately failed the victims. It's sickening and infuriates me that no one ever takes anything seriously. This isn't some fictional story. This happened to real people whose families have to live with what happened forever. And somehow some people are so disconnected with reality they can't comprehend that. That is the best fucking paragraph I've ever read in my life. And I guess that's where we're going to end it off. That paragraph right there said everything that it had that had to be said. And I couldn't have put it any better myself. The disconnect, bro. It's just saddening, man.
Baba Booey.
Baba Booey indeed. New York, Twitter says it plans to close the deal to sell company to Elon Musk after receiving offer. Corrects a previous AP News alert. Report that Elon Musk averted trial. I don't get it. Didn't Elon Musk say no to that already? Or is he still going to buy it? Don't mess with us Corpse Party fans. We've been waiting for Retro to play our game for 2 years on God. Allergies don't make any sense.
I have an allergy. I don't want to say just in case I have some secret nemesis I don't know about lurking in the fucking shadows waiting to find out my one true weakness, but I couldn't imagine having a nut allergy though. Like, them niggas living on
hard. Yo, true. Having a nut allergy, you guys are living life on hard mode. On hard mode. You know how much shit in real life has nuts?
Hard mode. Like, God must have really...
Bro, he said hard mode and I said the same shit.
Really put you on this planet just to die, nigga. What the fuck? Like, how severe do some of these allergies get, huh? Like, imagine you're sitting under an oak tree, a walnut falls on your head, now you're dead. Does it work that way, huh? Does it work that way? How do you even find out that you have a nut allergy, huh? How fast does it take for the smooth taste of peanut butter to close your airways as a child before they figure out, damn, we need to put a syringe full of steroids in this nigga's mouth? Hey, tell me, who'd win?
The one
who'd
piece win, okay? Is real. A human being. I'm gonna let you guys get that one.
Can we get much higher?
So high.
Or a spoon full of Nutella.
Man, I gotta be honest, bro. It would be me. I would dominate that spoonful of Nutella. That shit is delicious. You know, sucks to be a motherfucker with a nut allergy nowadays. I mean, y'all can't enjoy that nice, thick, warm, smooth.
I cannot lie, bro. I cannot lie to y'all, chat. I love peanut butter, and sometimes I be eating that shit just... I can have a little spoon and I just dip that shit in and I could just chew on peanut butter. Creamy or crunchy, both. Both of them for me taste good. I like the crunchy and I like the smooth. Peanut butter is
silky great. Peanut butter. Actually, now that I think about it, y'all might be onto something. Fellas, is it gay to not be allergic to nuts? Or is it gay to be allergic to nuts because God didn't trust you with the ability to choose? The thing that confuses me about nut allergies is, like, it's not even like a minor allergy. Like, your body goes on lockdown if a nut enters you. You break out in hives, your throat swells up. Like, what was your body's game plan, bro? That shit really was like,
this nigga ate a nut, shut him down.
Dear Ibsen kneecaps.
He ate a nut, shut him down.
I know you guys are just trying to make a good funny video about allergies, but my mom died eating a Clif's peanut butter bar after a workout. Could you tone down with the jokes for just a little bit, please? Bro, your mom got defeated by a nutty buddy, nigga? Your mom got defeated by a nutty buddy?
No, nutty buddy.
I said it was a Clif's peanut butter. You see, it's crazy how that nigga was talking to us like we were on equal footing or something. Did you see that, Ibs? Did you see that?
Man, this dude really thought we was finna agree. Oh, bro, your mama died because she got some nut in her? What? My fault, bro. My fault. No, literally my fault. I'll keep my nut to myself.
Okay, just checking. For a second there, I thought I was in the wrong. The nerve of these niggas, like, dog, you get defeated by a common tree squirrel. Yeah, if a squirrel bit you,
damn,
you roll over and die because of there being walnut particles in its saliva. Like, I could chew a peanut butter jelly sandwich, cough on a nigga, and they take poison damage. Yes.
Yeah, on God, bro. I can just...
That's not like some bullshit in Sekiro. A motherfucker's in a cave and Sekiro's allergic to freaking peanut butter. And me as an enemy, I'm there standing like... Sekiro, they're like, poison, oh shit. Poison damage, fuck, I can't do anything, dude.
Bust a nut on him like it's a Pokemon move, and that shit will do critical damage.
Damn.
All right.
Damn.
I'm done with the cum joke.
Get on his
ass. Keep it real, if you got a nut allergy, it's really nobody's fault. Yeah, really, except for your ancestors. Bro, they should not have passed their genetics, dog. How are you gonna be allergic to nuts, dog? Nuts?
Hey, what's up? What's
That's
up?
Unfortunate.
It's your boy Kneecaps. I just wanted to drop by to say, if you don't subscribe to Ibs, and if you don't like this video, I'm going to kill you.
You scare me now.
Hi.
Bro, it looks just like him.
Hi. This is so awkward talking to the camera for the first time. I'm Clay, also known as Dream. You may have heard of me or not. Well, this is my face reveal, and this is what I look like. I'm so happy to reveal my face to you, and I'm happy to be with friends and make IRL content. So, thank you for watching. I probably won't show my face in future videos, just a heads up, but yep, here's my face, so thanks for watching. Thanks.
You did good, Dream. Very good.
Oh, no.
It feels wrong not revealing my full face. I feel like I'm lying to everyone.
Shh, sweet baby. Does baby want some milk?
Yeah, that sounds great, actually.
Ew!
Here, latch.
Ew!
There you go, feed up. By showing your face, you have solidified your fan base even more. What was once a name, an icon, a symbol.
Bro, he's sucking on a long ass titty. What the fuck am I watching?
Now has a soul. Your fans will adore you even more. And we can milk me for more time to come. So much delicious milk for every teary-eyed fan who saw your face.
You make it sound so wrong. Like I'm manipulating millions of people who are irrationally attached to me in a deep emotional way.
No, Dream.
Come on. Feel dirty.
You're not dirty.
I'm not?
You're just hungry. Go on, latch your back. There you go. That's my sweet little prince. There he is. My little Dream. Yes, feed my little Dream. Feed until your belly is nice and full. We have so much milk to give.
I mean, it is Halloween month. Sephiroth and Kazuya amiibo. Where the Sora one? Where the Sora amiibo?
Think I'm on my way to the station.
Palate cleanser.
My frustration. Now I'm taking heat in the classroom. Pro well, I eat some donuts in the bathroom. Now I hear my friend at herself, a boyfriend. She going out for barbecue on the weekend.
You see all of the smiles and they pics online.
Well, all the boys, they're making me cry. Oh, my friends telling me, where can I find you? How do I remind you of the dream we share? But dreams are just for dream notes. Only hearts is immersed. I've got to break the chain.
Dang, bro.
Damn, I'm dead.
Costume's looking lit, bro. Ninja costume.
Costume's
looking lit, bro. Ninja costume. Dang, bro. Costume's looking lit, bro. Ninja costume. Dang, bro.
Bro, I gotta go to the mall just to make one of these videos. Why that skeleton made that noise, dude? Animals in Space, A Brief History.
Yeah, I'm causing a madness. Yeah, I'm fucking a badness.
Dream the entire duration of his face reveal.
Yeah, I'm causing a madness. Yeah, I'm fucking a badness. Yeah, I bought me the crown. Yeah.
Now I'm angry. You know why? Because now everybody's making a meme of we only saw one side of his face. Now we have to see the other side. That's like the new meme now. We don't know what Dream's other side of his face looks like. This is genuinely one of the worst fucking Rainmakers plays I've ever seen. You said, what was this, bro? Let's see. Damn, he tried to be extra. He tried to put it, like, farther away. Damn, it is what it is, man. It is what it is. They tried to... Never expected a Weather Channel to have RPG music. Never expected a Weather Channel to have... Wait, TWC Storm Alert 2006 theme? Yeah, I'm gonna be honest, bro. If we're at like a world is ending situation and I turned on my TV and this was playing, I think I would die. Like, Retro, get out the house. Retro, please get out the house. Hell no, bro. I'm jamming to the Weather Channel. Storm level 99, HP 69, 420 up. Robert Pattinson for getting Emma Watson's name and calling her that one. He's so real.
Get my name right.
I don't know, I think it's just wrong.
What's my name?
You look at the script, I think it's just wrong.
Just know my name.
How do you not know Emma Watson's name? It's Hermione Granger! Oh, this is during the movie. During the Goblet of Fire. Right? Cause he was in that movie for once in the Goblet of Fire, but then, spoiler alert. The movie's old. Robert Pattinson dies in the movie. He gets killed by Voldemort. And Voldemort's there like, I'm eating a dance. Like, every time Voldemort pops up, I'm like, yo, get ready to wheeze. Motherfucker pops up. And he's just like, the fucking spoon. He said, bro, why are you spoiled? Hey, man, this is a prehistoric movie.
My name, right?
How dare you do that to Emma Watson? She is a queen.
Oh my god, he looks...
What does he look? What does he look? Finish the sentence.
He has anime eyes.
I'm going to scream! Stay away from her!
Anime eyes? No, the fuck he does not. He looks like a regular ass fucking NPC that you would meet anywhere, bro. He does not have anime eyes. Yo, people gassed up his appearance like he's the second coming of Christ. He's a basic ass motherfucker. Damn. I feel like everybody's smoking crack. Wait, what the hell is this? I'm crying. The DID, the DID kids on TikTok think, no, I'm crying. Did kids on TikTok think Dream is ugly, so now they're undiagnosing? What? In regards to my introduction post, I am no longer a Dream interject, and I want nothing to do with my source. I know this post is later considering his face reveal was hours ago. I would not be able to live with myself knowing I was formed of him. I don't get it. Your quick reminder to Introdex that you don't need to identify with your source face or features or anything to be valid. Your discomfort with seeing your source is also valid. Remember that you aren't them. You're separate and that's okay. Bro, I don't give a fuck about anyone who's in this group. I don't know what the fuck this is. They're speaking an enchantment table. I don't give a fuck about who the fuck did is. But I'm getting the fuck out of here. I don't know what the fuck they're talking about. What the fuck is a did? What is a did? What is that? Dissociative identity disorder. Are you telling me people was identifying themselves as Dream's face? Yo. I don't want to get dark in this stream. But it would be fucked up right now if a Shinigami gave me a death note. All right, let's continue. I got to get the fuck out of here before. Wind Waker Pog. Nah, man. It's like when I start seeing this dumb shit, I start thinking to myself, maybe Light was right. When I start seeing a lot of this dumb shit online, I start thinking maybe Light was right. Maybe Light was the antagonist. No, not the antagonist, the protagonist, excuse me. Maybe L was the antagonist. Bro. Are they watching two puppies fight? I'm done, bro. I don't know what kind of third world country ass footage is this. This is some shit that I feel like somebody in Santo Domingo would send me. Don't be sending me these third world country battles, okay?
Oh my God, what a cute dog. Oh.
Yeah, his Doggy. Name's Timothy.
His name's Timothy?
Yeah, he's really cute, huh? Yeah.
His name's Timothy?
Yeah.
Oh my God, what a cute...
Yo, Rec Room is bugging out. Y'all bugging out on Rec Room. Y'all shot the dog? So a teacher and a student were arguing at my school today, and he said this. A teacher and a student were arguing?
I'm talking to your ass. That's who I'm talking to. Nah, you know me. You know me, and you know I ain't for the games. Stop talking to me, Dayana. Call your daddy then. Tell your daddy come up here and talk to me then. You, stop talking to me. No, I'm telling you, stop talking to me. Tell your daddy to come talk to me. Tell your daddy to come talk to me. Nah, go dig him up and tell him to come talk to me.
Get that bitch. Get that bitch. Get that bitch. You want to be so sour? Get her.
Tell your daddy to come talk to me. Nah, go dig him up and tell him to come talk to me.
After that, she can't say shit. After that, she can't say shit for the whole school year. They're going to be like, damn, Mr. Anderson in math class, he roasted the fuck out of you and your daddy. He said, dig that motherfucker back up. Damn, dude. Damn.
McDonald's has adult Happy Meals now. They know how to get our asses, don't they? Here's the toy. I'm going to say that for later. Try our Big Mac. You're never going to go wrong with a Big Mac. Fries.
Oh, shit.
Bomb ass fries. And of course, I got the high C. You already know. Taste of diabetes.
What's the taste toy? Of what's diabetes?
Fell in the fries. What the fuck is this? I want it like the Hamburglar. Or...
Bro, should I Uber Eats that shit to my crib right now? Bro, I should Uber Eats one of them shits to my crib. I don't think that shit's gonna make it here on time, though. 7 a.m. I gotta be there tomorrow. Thank you for taking this on such a late notice. I should send this guy a picture of my dick. On God. Like, I should just straight up just hit him with a... He gonna be like, huh? I'm about to be like... Can't forget under. Got all the angles, bro. I'm not trying to be like Dream. I'm not trying to just show one angle. I'm trying to show all my angles. All right. Oh, that's what I was doing. I was about to order this food. My God, my attention span is like an inkling. Uber Eats. I need to be whole. I got that fucking song stuck in my head, chat. My boyfriend. Fuck you guys, man. Y'all got that fucking song stuck in my head. Where the fuck that shit at? Fuck, it's gone. I will never find that shit ever again. It's gone. Play AI 2 then? Hell no. Bro, this box costs $16.48? Yo, what kind of... Yo! Bro, is there a cheaper meal? Why is this meal so expensive? Thank you. You say you got to buy it. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to buy it. Claim promotions. 70. Yeah. Put that pro. Oh, Uber Eats gave me like 3 promotions because they know I haven't ordered from this shit for like ever. They know I haven't ordered from this shit in mad long. Hold on. Can I order more toys? I want all the toys though. Chat, don't judge me, man. I know I sound like a fucking kid, but I want the toys. You said, bro, buy me a Happy Meal? No, I want the toys. But you know what I'm scared of? Every time I order something from McDonald's, they never give you the toy that's being advertised. They like to give you toys of, like, the previous shit that came out. Bro, if they don't give me the toys of what I want, that's going to piss me off. Oh, my Prince Charming, where could I find you? You said this man's 30. Shut up! Why you gotta tell everybody that? Oh, my Prince Charming, where could I find you? Bro, I'm trying to buy more toys. Why can't I buy toys on Uber Eats? Yo, where are the toys, bruh? I don't want milk. Hold on, I'm scrolling. I see a bunch of sundaes. I'm not trying to get all that, bro. Where is the... There we go. They don't want to sell the toy separately. Those bitches. I'm laughing because in the app, they buy three. You could buy three bacon strips for $2.29, and it's just a picture of three bacon strips by themselves. $3 for three bacon strips? You're smoking. Yo, I just want to buy a toy, dude. What? Okay, hold on. Let me see. Toy. Bro, they're not letting me get the toy. All right, fuck it. I'm just going to buy this shit. How much is it going to cost? It's already $16.48. Like, you guys are running a hard bargain. How much am I going to have to pay now? Next. This is so expensive. You said, nah, you an adult, you have to buy the food with the toy. But I want the toy. You said, what am I buying? All right, I placed the order. You know what I'm scared of? I told you guys this already. What I'm scared of is that they're going to give me the toy, but it's not going to be the toy of what I want. They're going to probably give me one of the Pokemon cards. And if they do that, I'm going to bug out. I'm going to take a picture for Uber and say, give me back my money. Because the whole reason of me buying this meal is to get the toy. You said motherfuckers is going to eat your food? I count my fries.
McDonald's has adult Happy Meals. They know how to get our asses, don't they?
Yo, if I get the Hamburglar or Grimace, I'll be happy. If I get what he got, I'll cry.
Toy, I'm gonna say that for later. Try our Big Mac. You're never gonna go wrong with a Big Mac. Fries.
Oh, shit.
Bomb-ass fries. And of course, I got the high C. You already know. Taste of diabetes. What's this toy? What's our toy? You fell in the fries. What the fuck is this?
If I get that, that's when I'm gonna be upset. If I get that shit, I'm gonna scream, bro. If I don't get Hamburglar or Grimace, pissed.
I want it like the Hamburglar or Grimace or something. This is nameless abomination. Damn. McDonald's has...
All right, let's go. It's the best one, though. Nah. My food's gonna be coming soon. Baby Keem couldn't handle the smoke machines.
Okay. I don't know anybody who's this.
Damn! How he said it. Yeah, that thing went right on him, dude. Yo, they hit him with a blast. They hit him with a whole cannon. Ruh-oh.
Ry-ro-ro you are. Ry-ro-ro-ro-win. There's a ringer in my rut, Raggy.
Please, what do you want from me? What? Oh, nah, this man was doing something. This tiny kitten grows up racing around her house.
She does look like a little T-Rex.
Where's his hands?
How upbeat she is constantly. She only has two little legs. That's
she's like
not
a little,
slowed her
she's
down
like a little T-Rex.
I think just because it happened when she was so young, probably she doesn't know any better. Somebody found her. She got brought into my sister's clinic, who wanted to try to save her life and had to amputate her poor little legs. She's probably chilling in the car engine and probably got her legs caught up.
Damn.
She survived that. My sister wanted to bring her over to foster.
You said put it out of its misery? Nah, he looked like he vibing out. Even though he don't got little hands, he vibing out. Just keep him inside the house and take good care of him.
And so probably in like the day of just having her, decided to keep her, met her.
It's very cute.
Just fell in love immediately.
It's so cute. It's so cute. It's like a little T-Rex. It don't got
duck.
Hands.
She
look.
She kind of waddled. She'd kind of take it slow. She'd waddle, trying to figure out her balance. I mean, she would try to stand.
It's
she'd
so
bounce
cute.
Pretty good. She picked it up almost immediately. But just getting around, getting used to everything, different surfaces. She wanted to just jump around, running around. Now she will book it around my house everywhere.
Bro, she's like a little T-Rex.
She hits a full upright like she's Usain Bolt around my house. Yeah, it's crazy. Just she's always the happiest little thing. Ooh, a lot of energy. Real playful. Always getting into something.
The easiest way to catch a kitten: take a bag, set it on the ground, shake it a little bit, and boom, you got yourself a kitten.
He likes moseying around the house, comes and finds you. And
it's very cute. The only thing that I would recommend is, for the love of God, do not let that cat go outside. Because if any other cats see that cat, they're going to be like, this bitch got no hands. And I know this is going to sound very unfortunate. And it's a girl cat. Don't let her go outside. Don't let her go outside. Because these guy cats out here are going to be like, she ain't got no hands. Lock the doors. Keep her ass in the house.
Shake my hand.
Ew. The Princess and the Frog? This is so creepy.
Shake my hand.
Come on, boy. Won't you shake a poor sinner's hand? Yes.
Are you ready?
Are you ready? Shake my hand.
Bro, this guy gives me Spamton vibes. Like, he look like he about to sell me something. Wow, Corin.
Believe it or not, I've been to a similar festival in my own world.
Oh, she looks so cute. Wow, that is an essay, my guy. Okay. I ain't reading all that. Oh, and she actually turns to her transformed thingy. Why does this shit keep popping up? With a crown. That's cool. With a Halloween decoration. Male Corin.
Is this how wizards really dress? I love the hat.
Distance stance. Unit can counterattack regardless of foe's range. If foe initiates combat, grants res plus 5 to unit. Damn, that kind of sucks. So it's not built into the weapon? You gotta have that as an A slot? Is this girl's? Does she have distant counter? I think she does. I think Moonlight Stone. I think it is. So-
Trick or treat!
Oh, my Prince Charming, where could I find you?
A costume? I've never donned such clothing before. Does it look strange?
Naga! Ooh, I like the little halo around her. Oh, the ghost moves and the freaking thing has a hat. That's cute.
To think a day would come
Duma?
When we could enjoy ourselves like this.
Indeed, it is truly a wonder.
Duma, who the hell is that? I done? The woeful upheaval. You saw that bullshit? Woeful upheaval. At the start of turn one, deal 7 damage to all foes. That's crazy. At the start of turn one, everybody gets damaged with 7 regardless of range. Reduces damage from foes first attack during combat by percentage equals difference between the unit's attack and foes attack. Difference between foes max HP and foes current HP at the start of combat. If foe uses bow, dagger, magic staff and initiates combat against... What? I can't see what that shit says. What does it say, bro? The shit's in my way. I can't see it. Oh, there it is. I should have just taken my cursor off. Did it say what? Savior? It has Savior? What? Oh, this unit's broken.
Our blessing upon you.
Neutralizes any penalty. Restores 30 HP and grants neutralizes foes bonuses from skills like Fortify during combat for one turn to unit and allies within 5 rows and 5 columns centered on unit. That's so good. So he could heal everybody by 30 HP and grants neutralizes foe bonuses? What?
My sister.
Yes, Duma. What fun.
Onward.
Indeed.
I don't even care who's this other unit. I still can't believe that Splatoon is literally gameplay lore. The lore is not that dark. Nice.
Something.
Oh, y'all, my 6-year-old niece wild. Oh, shit. At 6 years old?
Something.
What?
Look at this.
Damn, horny off rip.
Look at what she's searching
up. Haley did it.
Haley definitely did not do it. It was you.
Y'all not about to be watching any TV if y'all don't stop.
Haley did it.
Haley did not do it.
No more YouTube.
No.
I'm gonna block YouTube.
No more.
Get her back to her mom, and no more YouTube. Find a show to watch.
Nah, first of all, you shouldn't even let her go on regular YouTube. She's supposed to be going on the fucking, on the child version of the shit. The child version of the shit is ass, but hey, you're gonna watch child shit. Haley did nothing wrong.
Love, no time.
What? Guess who?
When I reach 45 months, I'm coming over and slapping your dick. Soda Despair.
Damn, you're gonna slap my pee-pee? Thank you, Owl. Thank you for the subs. I appreciate you. Thank you, baby. Dream, guess who? I'm crying, help. Single, by the way. Love, no time. And you gonna stay single. Y'all can stay calling a 16-year-old ugly creature, but here's a reminder, I'm hotter and more successful than any of you. Okay, buddy. You shop at Claire's. And you got a Casetify phone. If you're 16, you're probably his type. Oh! The boss, baby! Yo, the act! He said, you're about to get cooked. I'm praying.
Never heard of
him. Oh! Supposed to care. Did he just slap a butt? Supposed to
care. Never heard of him. Supposed to care.
That Yeet song went hard in the background with it. Oh my god, no, Yeet is back. Yo, he didn't care, bro. He used his body as a vessel. He did not give a fuck. This man just said, fuck it, man. I'm about to use belly drum and get my attack stats maxed out. He did not care. Pito, I can heal that man. Go. Yo. Let me just, why can't I retweet it? Let me retweet. Oh, you probably have your account private or some shit. Quote tweet. Is that a... This cannot... What? This kid cannot... Get the phone. So true. Bro, leave the snake alone, dude.
Alright, they never go...
When you decide to flank...
Oh, hey, but I'm gonna check anyway. Alright, bet we're going B.
First off, I'm an individual. So I won't be going to A or B. I have the perfect plan. While the opposite team is completely occupied fighting my teammates, I'm gonna sneak behind enemy lines. I'm gonna play the long game, waiting for the perfect moment. And when that moment comes, I'll strike. I'll eliminate everybody on the other team and look crap as f*** to the whole lobby.
Bro. This was literally the Splatfest, bro. This was the Splatfest team grub. They stayed at the spawn and just did this.
Shooting at these guys. Literally, bro. Wait, what is this? One bullet is enough. One other bullet. Bro. I don't even know if I need another bullet, bro. It's like just simply someone else to aggro. I don't understand. Where's our teammate?
Last man standing.
Huh?
We're losing. If only there was one more person on our team. Just one more. Oh, man. Where's our other teammate?
We're
still in the game?
Oh,
he's in the backyard.
Ah, look at him.
Wow. Are you?
I'ma clutch up.
Shoot, you idiot.
Why did y'all die?
I'ma
clutch up.
Yo, you saw how quick he left the lobby? Oh my god, bro. This brought me back so hard. Yo, that brought me back to like Modern Warfare 2 days. This man left the lobby instantaneously, dude. Yo, give me a sec, chat. taste of resistance is here. We got it. We got it, boys. It better be in that Happy Meal thing. I swear, bro. What did I get? You said no toy, bro. Don't play with me. I'm looking inside. Why is my shit slightly open? He took my fries. Where my toy? Oh, I was about to say I got my toy. Should I open it right now? Let's open that bitch right now. Fuck it. I want to see what I got. Bro, if I didn't get Grimace, like, first time. Hold on. No. Ah! I said I didn't want this one, and this is the one I get. I can never win, bro. Dude. The same one, bro. Yo, I mean, bro, he's like the mascot. He even has like the McDonald's shirt. Bro, I wanted Grimace or the Hamburglar, bro. At least you got the worst one already. I'm gonna put him right here. I'm gonna put his ass right there. Damn, bro. I didn't even want that one. And they gave me that one. I could have gotten one. You can collect all four, right? I could have gotten Grimace, Birdie, or the Hamburglar, and they don't cook me and gave me Cactus. Who the fuck is Cactus? Cactus Jack? Cactus Plant Flea Market? I don't understand, bro. His name is Cactus. The Grimace one is the best one. It is, because he's purple and he got four eyes. They didn't allow me to order more toys, dude. I'm fucking angry, dude. I was gonna order like three or four of the toys, and they did not want me to do that. They were like, nah, you gotta order the Happy Meal, you bitches. Cactus Plant Flea Market. What? I don't understand. What is a cactus plant and why is it a flea market? Imagine you get four Cactus Jacks. That's my fear. That is my fear, that I'm going to get four of him. I'm going to get cucked and get four of him. The final battle was gas. I'm not spoiling myself.
And as promised, here are your Scooby snacks. Jinkies. And as promised, here are your Scooby snacks.
Damn. Damn. She's confirmed gay. I'm about to hit everyone with a damn. I never remembered asking. He said, I'll turn Velma back straight. Batman, I caught a little Pokemon.
Batman, I caught a little Pokemon.
The Lopunny.
You wanna know what Pokemon I caught?
What Pokemon did you catch?
I caught a Lopunny.
I caught a Lopunny, Batman.
I caught a Lopunny.
Oh no, Joker. Don't tell me.
No. You already know, Batman. You know what I'm gonna do to that thing.
Joker, it's an animal, Joker. You
no,
can't.
No!
Batman, there's no laws against the Pokemon, Batman. I can do whatever I want with it.
No, no, don't do it. No, don't do it.
I'm gonna do it, Batman.
I didn't see the last frame. I'm gonna do it, man. Yo, straight belly flopping.
I'm gonna do it, Batman. There are no rules with the Pokemon. There are no rules.
So someone burst into my class. I'm doing my work. Oh my God, Trevon, you gotta come quick. Your sister's crying. It's bad.
Damn.
I look at my teacher. I'm like, yo, I gotta
go. Be out.
Sister's crying.
It's mandatory.
Mandatory.
Right.
Run down the hall. I see my sister crying in the middle of a hall. I embrace her. Oh my God, sister, yeah. I'm here.
Hero.
What's going on? Yeah.
She said, oh my God, it's my boyfriend. He's the ambulance is taking him away. I was like, what happened? She said, oh, his knee popped out.
The knee popped out in high school? How did it pop out?
Now I'm just like, how the fuck does this happen? It's like, well, someone called him.
Nigga turned around. Nigga broke his leg responding.
Damn, like, really?
Yep. Look what you did. Look what you did, fool.
Call me. Like,
nah, bro.
Shoot me a text.
Nah, bro.
I told you to approach me from the front. You faced the
way.
Nah.
He looked up. Nigga turned with some urgency, cuz.
Yeah. I was about to say that. That must have been the hardest turn this man has ever done to break his leg. Uh-oh, chat. Uh-oh. Zero. Yo. Now let me see. Ruthless how people dogging him for being fat. At least he put in the work. Most won't.
Is my nigga made of paper?
Maybe. Maybe. Thank you for the bits, Owl. I appreciate that. He says, at least he put in the work and won't, and that most won't. I don't even like the dude or his content, but it seems the internet is cool with destroying men's appearance so long as they have an excuse to not like you. Also shameful how I see a lot of girls who claim body shaming is a sin, but are all on the dogging on this dude. Bro, I've been saying this shit for a long time. When you talk badly about a woman, they all rise against you and then they're like, oh, body shaming this, body shaming that. But if a dude gets body shamed, nobody says shit about it. And they just keep moving on with their day. And it's bullshit because this does happen a lot. You should want the talk, but I guess decent values are too much for society these days. They'd be so different if it happened to them. Velma's officially lesbian in the new Scooby-Doo film. How do you know that? What if she's just bisexual? Creator confirmed it. Soul Menace? I mean, for what purpose? You said she was dating a bunch of dudes before. I mean, they most likely did this for money and inclusion. Because let's be honest, no company really gives a fuck about people's ethnicity and all that other shit or people's sexual preference. They just want money. So they most likely did this because they knew it was going to get likes, clicks, and now this is why it's trending. Because they did that. It's just free publicity for their shit. You said LGBTQ do be doing numbers down? Of course. Why do you think every company, when it gets close to like, I forgot what month it is. What was it, like February or March? They all start changing their colors. They don't do it because they give a fuck about the community. They do it because they want money. They just want to look good. Oh, it's in June, bro. I don't even know the months, bro. I'm bugging the fuck out. And then the second the month is over, they just swap back. You said don't hog all the fries? Bro, I'm sad I gotta go to work tomorrow. It's so hypocritical. People who are doing it mainly don't like him because of something he did in the past. Bro, what did he do in the past? It's like people, that's another thing I don't understand about people on the internet. They will be so caught up in the past. You said be racist? He was racist? I don't remember that. He said racist stuff as a teen? Bro, how long ago was it? And I'm gonna be honest, I ain't gonna crucify anyone for saying stupid shit when they were a teenager. Why? Because everyone has done it. Everybody in their teenage years have done some stupid ass shit that they regret. Why? Because everybody was young. Everybody was infantile. What I don't like about Twitter is that everybody acts like as if we're all saints and they have never committed a mistake. And the most people, right? The person that talks the most shit about you probably has even more skeletons in their closet than the person they're talking shit about. But it's the internet. Like a person will come at you like, oh my God, I can't believe you said the N-word in sophomore year in high school 10 years ago. And I'm like, okay, it's unfortunate, yeah. But like I keep saying, people don't give people the chance to evolve. Like, yeah, people say stupid shit. People has done stupid shit. Is it like excusable? I guess it depends on the person. But honestly, I'm not gonna be out here looking at someone's life and then being like,
us. Well, go ahead. I would love to hear this. Yo, Blaze.
Y'all been asking Blaze for this one for a while. So we're here to figure out who's Blaze, the best Attack on Titan.
Blaze.
Titan. You.
Dude, nobody cares. It's Aaron. He has like three inside him anyways. Sorry for the spoilers.
Bro, you just ruined my video.
True.
How long you been standing there?
About 60 minutes.
Does he know the exact time?
Anyways, do you like PlayStation or Xbox better?
PlayStation.
Even though they got rid of the web browser for PS5?
The web browser? That's your arguing point?
Exactly. Like, who the fuck is on a fucking console to go on the internet when I have my fucking computer, I have my fucking cell phone? Like, who the fuck out here really like, oh, don't mind me, I'm browsing the internet on my console. Like, what year is this, bro?
Who thinks about a web browser when they get a PS5?
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Yo, shut your bitch ass up. I wish I was in this skit, bro. I would have looked at Xbox. Shut your bitch ass up. What games you guys got?
What you should be worried about is how you gonna rebuttal against the state of play they just dropped, because they was dropping nothing but heat. What are you dropping? Oh, wait, you ain't got one of those, do you? You don't got even any exclusives right now. What is you working with, Forza?
I'm surprised you don't get Forza, Gears non-existent, Halo flop. What you guys got? Don't, like, you guys might as well give Nintendo back Banjo-Kazooie, because I ain't even doing nothing with the IP. I'm talking my shit. Just give Nintendo back Rare, give Nintendo back Banjo-Kazooie. They'd probably do a better job anyway, because Banjo-Kazooie 1 and 2 was gas. Where's Banjo 3? That nuts and bolts shit was dog shit. They look ugly. Their character designs were ugly. The game's concept was ugly. Everything about the game is ugly. Bring back Grant Kirkhope 2.
In the three rings of death.
It's just Forza at this point. Halo folding. You said what? 100% did this godforsaken game and Persona 5 are in a few weeks. What game? Yo, you did the remake, bro. This game is hard to try to platinum. How many hours? 113 hours, chapter 18? Oh my god. You are crazy. Sora, it was hard, right? I can imagine that shit was annoying because you have to do the game on hard mode.
It was nice while it lasted, Yugi. But with this next card, this duel is over. I activate the Flute of Summoning Dragons. With Lord of D on the field, I can special summon up to two dragon monsters from my hand. And I choose the Blue Eyes White Dragon.
Not so fast, Kyber. I have a card of my own. I activate Multiply. I can special summon up to as many Kuribo tokens as I please. And I choose to summon an infinite amount.
Wait, no, you can't summon it.
But that's not
true. That this part of the show made no sense. This was actually just show bullshit. This was TV show anime bullshit. This man Yugi said, I can have unlimited tokens. No, the fuck you can't. That is not how the rules go.
Not all. For Kuribo is a noisy creature, and with an infinite amount of him, it gets infinitely louder. So much louder that it's too loud for the dragons to hear the Lord play his flute, meaning you can't summon those dragons.
All right, listen, Yugi, that's just bullshit, all right? That's not how the game works.
Well, you explain to me, Kaiba. If they can't hear the flute, then how are you going to summon
that's
them?
That's not... There was so much wrong with what you just said.
Just play your next card, Kaiba.
You know what? I will. You think that's going to stop me, Yugi? Fine. I don't summon my Blue Eyes White Dragon from my hand. But you know what I do? I activate Monster Reborn to special summon the Blue Eyes White Dragon from my graveyard.
A foolish mistake, Kaiba.
What?
It's in the name, Kaiba. The dragon is not just brought back. He is reborn, completely without memory of his previous life.
What?
And as unfortunate as it is, Lord of D on the field is a very scary looking guy.
What does that even
Unlike
mean?
My many Kuribos, who have uncertainty of who to trust, he will choose me. And so the Blue Eyes White Dragon will fight on my side of the...
That's not how any of this works, Yugi. You can't just make this up as you go along. There are rules and structures for this game. This isn't make-pretend, Yugi.
Kaiba, I am using very sound logic here.
You know what? Fine. Let's play it your way, Yugi. I attack with Lord of D.
You must forget, Kaiba. I have your Blue Eyes White Dragon.
Ah, but you see, Yugi, the Lord of D is the Lord of all dragons. So the Blue Eyes White Dragon must obey his command.
I should have seen that coming. Fortunately, I did. For I have Big Shield Gardener in defense position.
Well, I'm sure you know Big Shield Gardener's peanut allergy.
Is what?
Well, guess what Lord of D had for lunch?
Oh, Yugi, you fucked up. Now Kaiba gonna start playing in his antics. He said he got a peanut allergy?
Today.
Well, you bet, Kaiba. Big Shield Gardener gets on the back of Cannibal Turtle.
They all just summoning monsters at this point. Where are the tributes?
Launching him away from your Lord of T and his peanut breath.
Yeah, well, Lord of T can jump really, really high and catch him in the
air. Not higher than the wall of Infinite Karibos.
Not unless he rides on the back of Blue Eyes White Dragon, which he
but
does.
But the rebirth process also gave him a new fear of physical contact.
That's why Lord of T had a heart-to-heart talk to him and help him overcome his fears.
You can't do that.
Well, I did.
Oh, you did. It's not fair. It's not fair. It's bullshit. It's not even fair. I can't even do it. I destroy the moon.
What moon? There is no moon.
Fuck you.
He said, I destroy the moon? Yo, we haven't even landed there yet. Like, you're crazy. You're crazy for that one, Yugi. We haven't even landed there yet. All right. Nintendo changes policy. No longer allows games with uncensored bared breasts. Nintendo L. Wear the bare breasts. Wear the bare breasts. I thought Nintendo was cool. So hashtag no free the nipple. Wear the nipple. I want to see. Let's continue.
32 mil metros. Le está costando subir, creo. ¿O no? No, no, va rapidísimo.
Hay un silencio absoluto, ¿no?
Is that an Among Us?
Imagínate estar ahí, Capri.
Hay como ruido blanco, ¿no?
La nada. Imagínate levantarte, levantarte en la mañana.
¡Oh, no! ¡No! 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 ¡No, no, no, no! No, cago. No, 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 va. Va en picada, va en picada, va en picada. ¡La compro, la compro! ¿Le pusieron garantía extendida, la compro? ¡No! ¡Perdimos la señal! ¡No! Rest in peace. For popular demand, the specific moment when the nugget reaches its maximum distance from Earth's surface, it starts to fall towards Earth's atmosphere. Rest in peace, Among Us Nugget. You said, did you see the moon? I think I can see it right now, but best believe it's probably not even the moon. Maybe it's just a light bulb in the sky. Maybe this world is a simulation. Maybe, just maybe, we are all inkling and squid and everything around us is just scales. Maybe. That's why sometimes I just want to ink stuff. Gazer, Gazer. The Japanese government is warning that North Korea appears to have launched at least one ballistic missile. There's a possibility it's heading towards Japan. The
this
government
the
is urging everyone in the country
to
take shelter
FF7.
Immediately.
Ah, this super boss was complete nah, this without shit ain't a real. Guide and I still played unoptimal.
Shit, that's not real. Oh no.
Oh yeah, yay, bro.
Where the fuck this shit opened at? Oh no. Gotcha, bitch. Gotcha too. Oh, I've never fought this guy. You're showing me a video of the guy with the spiky hair. I've never fought him. Plus, I need to play the DLC, so I don't think I could even watch this if I'm going to be real with you. Because I wanted to play the DLC of this game and actually fight him. Yeah, that's spoilers. Spoilers. I don't know when I'm going to get around to it, but I'm going to get around to it. Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget, your man's the sloppiest of the toppiest tonight. International Boyfriend Day is celebrated in October 3rd. A.
Listen, ladies out there, who be dick sucking? And know how to do it right? Bad. Y'all be getting it wet? Y'all motherfuckers be, y'all be using the two-handed technique? I gotta give a moment of respect to all the ladies out there who put time, effort, dedication, consistency, repetition to their dick-sucking skills.
Facts.
God knows that it's not easy to out here to find a girl who knows how to suck some good dick.
Facts.
So those who dedicate themselves to the practice, you'll get my unfounded respect, admiration, and support. Thank you for taking so much initiative to make life better for everyone else on this planet. And by all means, I hope your endeavors for the future are supported and successful. And anything else that you ever do has the same success, the same consistency as your dick sucking. Thank you, ladies. Thank you.
Yo, that shit's gonna be immortal. The housekeeper. I haven't seen this guy in forever.
Huh? I'm not playing these games!
not playing these games.
Do you need any assistance with your bags?
Don't touch them!
Of course, sir!
Bro.
Is this where I check in? I would like to check in, please. First and last name, please.
Lucas.
Ah,
here you are.
So you got the single queen bed suite?
That is correct.
Okay, so it seems like your room has been fully paid for a two-night stay. What card would you like to use for the $700 deposit fee? Don't worry, you'll get all your money back after your trip. This is just for us to hold, just in case of any damages, property loss, etc.
Ah, I see. Okay, well, I got this card.
Stop touching my bag!
Your bag!
The hell are you talking about?
This is mine!
My name is on it!
That's my baggage claim ticket! I just came from the airport!
Me too!
Oh, really? What airline you flew?
Mind your damn business!
Oh, you talking to like that?
I'm talking to the person in front of me!
Huh? I'm over here.
Oh. What I'm talking...
So you're just yelling at a random person?
You! I'm proving this!
I mean, he is looking directly at you, so I think it is fair to say that...
Shut up! You keep talking like you want to do something!
You think I won't?
I know you won't!
I'll smush your face right now!
Then do it!
Smush...
Damn!
You're right. I mean, he did tell you...
Oh, my goodness. He really did that.
So y'all not gonna stop this?
Oh, don't mind them. That's just the Wednesday entertainment.
Oh!
That's crazy. And it's all himself.
All right. It seems like everything is ready for you. Your room number will be 802. The elevator is over there to your right. Here's your key card. Please, enjoy your stay with us.
Thank you.
Yeah, by the way, you going up. We'll handle your bags for you.
It's such a great day to watch a man do a 200-meter sprint with a bag of luggage, ain't it, Bobby?
Yes, indeed it is, Cornell.
On your marks. Get set.
It's getting intense.
And you're off.
We picked a great day to do this.
What? Did he just take his luggage? What building is he in? Is that his house?
Housekeeping!
Hmm. This room is definitely, different. Vintage. Feels lived in.
Oh my gosh.
What's in here? A fully stocked
closet. He got pictures of his parents lying around and shit.
Yeah, this is definitely nothing I've ever seen before. I'm assuming anyone could just take these clothes and they just charge through the room or something. Huh, I guess.
It is dad.
The hell is the bathroom? All right, I need to rest for a few minutes.
Housekeeping?
No, thank you.
Housekeeping?
No, no, but thank you.
Housekeeping?
I'm saying no. N-O, no.
She about to barge in.
That was odd.
Housekeeping?
No, no, thank you.
Housekeeping?
I just got in here.
Housekeeping?
Listen to me. So no housekeeping?
What the hell?
Get out of here.
Yeah, that's not happening again.
What's wrong with this place?
Housekeeping?
Bro, I keep trying to tell you. I don't need no damn housekeeping.
Housekeeping?
Bro, you might as well just go out and beat her ass, because at this point, the person who's trying to housekeep, they don't understand. Beat their ass.
Leave me alone. Take the day off. You don't have to work this hard. God. God. Oh, God, how is he doing this?
I'm not the only one in this hotel.
There's 25 doors.
Really? You a liar.
What happened?
I fell asleep. Dummy. Wait. Hello? Hello? Is anybody here?
You don't have to yell in my ear. I'm right beside you.
Literally right beside you.
Oh. What's going on here?
They keep housekeeping. So much housekeeping.
But where did it even go?
I mean, I have no idea. I looked away for 1 second. My door slammed open, but he wasn't behind it. He's gone. So go riddance. Am I right? We're free. Finally.
Housekeeping.
What?
Oh, God. Wow.
I never leave the house. I knew I should have stayed at home.
He yoinked them.
What's wrong with me?
Wow. They're fixing the fishing. Why? Not the feather duster. He's replacing the towels.
please. Housekeeping. I'm not playing these games.
He said the thing. He said the thing. He said the thing.
Housekeeping. No. Housekeeping. What's that? What is that? I know I need that. I'ma get it. I'ma get it.
Open up. I'm scared of housekeeping.
This is exactly what I need. Now, how do I do this?
Just open the door, punch him, put it on the doorknob. He defeated him.
Hey, is this where I come to check out?
I would like to check out.
So soon? Okay, well, let's get your bag down for you. Check me out, please.
Sure.
Back up for me.
Huh?
Okay.
Okay. No, well, check me out, bro. Like, he legit started checking him out.
10, I'm gonna give you a strong 7. And that's me being nice. I feel like you have a lot of features that could be worked on. Like, first off, your chin is kind of... It's 6 o'clock already? The show's about to start.
Stop touching my bag!
What the hell you talking about? This is mine!
My name is on it!
That's my baggage claim ticket! I just came from the airport!
Me too!
What airline you flew?
Mind your business, David!
No, no, it's gonna be another person going through the same shit. What happened to the guy who was in the room next to him? Did he get sucked up to like, the... Guys, the fucking soap shoes are back. It's fucking over. No, the fuck it's not, bro. You said, hold up, Frontiers might be lit? This is what's gonna make the game lit for you? Them getting these shoes? It's over, we won! Bro, this game gonna be so ass. This game gonna be so ass, and I can't wait to play it.
Do I know you from somewhere?
Did he just... Is that how he killed Carl? Chat? Chat, is that how he killed Carl? Chat, it's 9 o'clock. I'm sorry, but today's a short stream because now I gotta go to work tomorrow, apparently. It sucks. It sucks. It sucks. It sucks. Yo, true, that's me.
Damn.
Bro, she got a sharp ass chin. From an empty sea, a flash of
light. It will take a while.
Rest in peace, Bozo. Most discussed games. What's the other games? Hogwarts, Sonic Frontiers. Damn, that sucks. So much people are talking about this game, bro. Top 10 places I've been fucked in. In the spawning grounds. True. I've been definitely fucked over there a bunch of times.
Fucking bitch. Yeah, get his ass. Fucking pussy. Try the fuck again, bitch.
Yo, that's me. That's me.
Fucking bitch. Yeah, get his ass. Fucking pussy. Try the fuck again, bitch. Try the fuck again.
Yo, that's me, dude. I felt that spiritually. Can I help you today?
Yo, can I get a Gran Gonzalo chopped in half with a Kuro Galileo seasoning and a little bit of that Town Biz spice? Show!
Yes, sir, may I help you today?
Let me get a cheeseburger with macaroni and cheese on a pancake.
Show!
First, we take Gran Gonzalo. Then we chop them up into pieces. Then we take the Halle Lily Uwu. Then we take the Star-Lord J. Put them in the grill. Then we take Afrogenics.
First, put the bacon on the grill. Then you put the bacon on the grill. So we butter the grill. Now we pour the pancake on the grill. We put the fries on the grill. The mac and cheese is ready. Now we put it on top of the pancake. After the burger is ready, now we season it up. Then we add the cheese on top of the burger. The fries ready. Now we put it on top of the pancake. Then we put the bacon on top of the macaroni and cheese. Once the cheese is melted, now we put the burgers on top of each other. Now we put it on top of the pancakes. Last and final, now we put the spinach on top of the bacon.
Everything. That's like the one healthy thing on it. The little spinach on it. Like, okay, thank you. Like, why even put the spinach on it? I'm sorry.
It's ready, now we stack them up. Now we put it on top
of that should look like it's bussin'.
Can't forget the Fabevsky, never never.
The Fabrinsky, the Fabevsky. Sure, can't forget Fabrinsky, never never never. Now we serve it to the customer. It tastes great.
Bit of paper. Now we wrap it up.
And the result is...
OMG!
Can't forget your bed.
Never, never, never.
Now we serve it to the customer.
That was so cringy. Who the fuck is this? Is he like a Viner? He looks like he's... Because like, does he have a t-shirt of himself? Is that him on the t-shirt? Molly?
Never.
Why he said it like that, bro? Why he said it like that? Never, never, never. You ruined it, bro. You said, I experienced every human emotion in the span of 6 seconds. I think I've seen this clip. Damn, the push into the lid. How lucky. The other week I saw you asking what games you should play. I have 3 games to suggest with a 4th honorable mention. What? Project X Zone 2? What? Hyperdimensia Neptunia. I think somebody sent me that. Intro Another Centuries? I never heard of these games. I've never heard of those games. What? Oh, nah, you just got that dookie-ass Wi-Fi. Not even Comcast. Dude got Sprint. Dude got Sprint. Nah, bro, you got Sprint. The Zazu internet. Sneaking got permabanned on YouTube. Sneeko! They permaband Sneeko? Look at his response. L plus speed owns you. Yo, they banned Sneeko, dude. That's crazy. Yo, that's crazy. There is no freedom of speech. Because look, here's my thing. If you don't agree with what somebody is saying, just don't listen to them. But the fact that you banned him is proof that like freedom of speech really doesn't exist. Who was Sneeko? Sneeko was like a guy that was similar to Andrew Tate, where he talked about specific topics in terms of like relationships and how everything is going. He was very similar to Andrew Tate. But my thing is, like I said before, is banning them, in my opinion, is not a good idea, because you don't give people the chance to even debate with them. So I just feel like it's weird that you're going to ban them, but that sucks. This sounds chaotic and I love it. What is even, what even is Salmon Run Music? Nah, Salmon Run Music is gas. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. It's gas. I saw nothing wrong with it. That's what music is. Little buddy jump scares? Where? Fidel got Twitter elite privileges. Where's my edit button? Oh no. Oh! Oh! Yo, that is the realest. That picture was like the perfect expression. That picture, bro. Yo, not the glow flies. GG's. 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 I love how they form an R every time they pose. Okay. Yo, can we all unanimously agree that Jesse is hot as fuck? Like, I wish Jesse, if I'm even in a proximity of her, bro, oof. The R, baby. Woo-wee! Also, one thing I gotta agree with, James was sexy as hell when it was the old voice actor. James. Now they got, like, this other version of James that sounds like this. I sound like I got a pencil up my butt. Last, the James before him, sexy. Straight sex appeal, bro. That's an R? Wakanda Forever is another trailer? Copyright Pog. DMCA Pog.
Only the most broken people.
Yo, this movie's gonna be so good.
Can be great leaders.
His people did not call him general or king. They called him Kukulkan, the feather serpent.
Kukulkan.
killing him will risk eternal war.
He's coming for the surface world.
We know what you whisper.
He got the Legend of Zelda, the feather shoes.
Show them who we are.
Oh my God, I have chills. I have chills, bro. Oh my God, yo, this movie's gonna be so fucking good. And then you saw the guy with the Legend of Zelda feather boots? Dude was running in the air.
James's voice in the sub is goated toe.
Damn. Bro, you sending me this clip? Bro, we ain't talking about no fucking sub. I have never in my life watched Gen 1 of Pokemon in Japanese. We're talking about English. This is the American servers. What are you doing in the American servers?
All right. Oh, hold on, my bad.
Oh, no, I'm scared. What is he about to show? Me trying to open a 10-year-old game facts guide on a forgotten JRPG. Now, I'm kind of scared to see what that was going to pop up because this is academics. What's going to pop up on this shit? I'm kind of scared. You said it's safe? You sure it's safe? Bro, I'm trying not to see a random ass titty pop up on his feed.
My man, I was wiping some shit off. Pause.
Exiting narrator. El narrador se ha cerrado inesperadamente. Si esto no se esperaba, visite el sitio web oficial de Microsoft.
I don't know what the fuck is happening.
Sí.
Oh, now he just drunk off his mind, bro. He don't know what the fuck's going on. I bought Splatoon 3. I am done playing Splatoon 3. It's a furry post, isn't it? If you want to get right to it, check out the lobby or follow that weirdo down the sewer. Up to you. Dream face reveal? Yeah, dream stance forcing themselves. Dream is hot. I don't know what anime this is, but this shit look like it's dark. Top 40 savage segments in Rex and wrestling companies. No, thank you. We seen that. Pokemon Mystery Dungeon humor. Man, I've never played the game, so I don't understand what's happening.
Oh, this is all my fault. Stupid.
Hey, come on. It's not your fault. You're just a...
Yeah, you can't help it. You're just a...
Okay, stop.
The communication error. Oh, man. It's beautiful. The PlayStation 5 has been jailbroken. It took 1 year, 10 months, and 21 days for the PS5 to be jailbroken. The question is what can you do when it's jailbroken, though?
I think I saw this video. Chimera Arc. Gon and Killua completing Greed Island. Yo, true. True. Yo, I was like, yo, Greed Island was awesome, man. And I remember watching it. We went to the castle. We had the card. We saw the guy with the fuzzy hair. We're like, yo, Greed Island was gas. Next thing you notice, we run into the guy with the big-ass hat. What's his name, chat? The guy with the big-ass hat. I forgot his name. Kite. He had the weirdest fucking name, Kite. Whose name is Kite? But then once Kite showed up, everything went downhill. I must be the dumbest person on earth. I'm in tears. I just almost burned down my house. I can't believe how dumb I am. I wanted to microwave my leftover burger. You left the aluminum foil, didn't you? But I left the okay. I came back to the microwave and the whole thing was on fire. I'm shaking. Bleach Coca-Cola? Corpse husband watching Dream get... Corpse husband watching Dream get cooked on the timeline. True. Yo, I can imagine, yo, this motherfucker Dream, I said Dream, Corpse husband probably was like,
I'm probably gonna do a face reveal.
Saw that shit?
Never mind.
He's staying his ass home. He is not going out. He is not doing this face reveal. And you know why I feel like if Corpse Husband does a face reveal, it's going to be even worse than Dream's revealed because of just how much people was legit dick riding him. Like, there is so much people they're dick eating Corpse. Like, they see this motherfucker's hands and they're like, oh my God, he's so veiny. Oh, he's so muscular. Oh, look at his nails. Oh my God, when the face reveal happens... I'm just going to be here. I ain't even going to lie. He probably going to be looking like an average looking dude. And I'm not even going to roast him. But the internet is going to go crazy on his ass. Me after replying ugly under Dream's face reveal. Putting my phone on vibrate in my ass. True. He looks like if Quagmire was drawn by Fujoshi. I don't even know who that is. We live on the beach in Florida. We stayed through the Hurricane Ian. Thought I share a rather notable photo from the experience. That's the water. Clap for the man that installed those windows. Do women not install windows in the U?
Cállate la boca, mamagüevazo. Pero quién está hablando de esa vaina?
Do women not install windows in the U.S.? Shut your bitch ass up, man. Nobody said that. Shut the fuck up. Please, right? Come on, man. We're looking at a photo and we're just like, yo, shout out to the dude who installed that window. Oh, so women can install. Nobody said that. Nobody said that woman can't do that. Just talk about the picture, please. Hollow Knight. Yo, where's Silk Song though? I take back everything I said about Splatoon 3. It's goated. You better. Retro and Salmon Run. I want to live every single game I play tonight. We got wiped by glow flies. That is me. Look, boom, boom, boom. I want to live. Everybody behind me is next to me. We got the fat ass dude swinging the freaking frying pan. We got the freaking, what else? We got the damn freaking flies shooting the missiles. We got the, with the big ass nozzle nose. From across the fucking map. The One Piece is real. Okay, that might be a spoiler. I don't know shit about it, but take me with you.
Let's go.
Nigga, I'm on. Nigga, 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 and nigga, do.
I'm done. Yo. What the fuck, dude? I'm done. Okay. Ba-ba-da-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba- based on a true story. That's us. That's me, Owl, Lily, and Gonzalo. Ooh, with the Banjo-Kazooie voice. Nice touch.
Okay. Okay, I got this. Yeah, those salmonids won't even know what hit them. Wait, hold on. Is that guy's username Shut Up? I get it. This guy's probably tired of having teammates who are always spamming communication signals. Don't worry, Mr. Shut Up. For this round of Salmon Run, I'll take a vow of silence. I promise.
You Hell no, bro. I get hit, I'm spamming that ouch button. The second I go, ouch, 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 I'm spamming that ouch button.
You're a single peep from me this entire game.
Oh no, you did it.
I'm so sorry, Mr. Shut Up. I failed you.
That's how the video ends? Bro, people can say booyah to me all they want. I will not booyah back unless we win. Like, I'll look you in the eyes and I'm like, bitch, you think I'm gonna booyah? I am not booyahing. Unless I see that we won and I get my shells, then I'll booyah. Other than that, I'm not booyahing shit. I don't wanna booyah. Woo me, woo me. Damn. Oh.
No wires here, Fred. Wow, a real case of levitation. This just gets better and better. Maybe from where you're standing. Anybody want to try getting me down?
Yo, Velma kind of thick. Velma kind of thick, bro. Son. Yo, what's going on?
Yo, you coming, G?
Nah, you guys going.
Well, nigga, you gonna be at the function, bruh?
I don't think so, Barney.
Why? What the fuck's your prom?
The thing is, I can't dance like the rest of them.
Bro, what the fuck you mean, dog? Get the fuck out here and get your fucking groove on, dog.
I can't dance at all. I don't know how.
Nigga, that shit easy, bro. Watch this. You just hit this shit like this real quick.
Shake that butt. Shake that butt. Baby, get...
I look silly.
Nah, bro. You just gotta hit this shit like this.
Down, gon' shake that butt. Just shake that butt.
I can't, Barney.
Nigga, if my fat ass can do it, you can get out and fucking dance.
I'm just gonna go home. Bye, guys.
Fucking baby bop.
Well, bye, Jamal.
Whatever, nigga. What's good, nigga? Dude, I had a question before you go. I kind of know what the problem is.
What are you talking about, Barney?
Look, I was thinking about it, and then I looked down and I saw your shits. I had to ask you, what are those?
Damn, my dude is wearing the freaking loafers. Dude out here wearing Splatoon drip. I can't even lie. That this is an actual Splatoon shoe in the game. Dude got fucking sub saver on that bitch.
What's wrong with them?
Nigga, what's wrong with them? You got on the Benjamin Franklin Civil War loafers. Penny loafer, no penny having 1920s hobo looking road circuit security shoes. And you thought I was finna let your socks slide, my G. Your socks look depressed, bro. You don't have the calf muscles to keep your shits up your leg, my guy. You took the socks and the shoes together out the lost and found, bro. Go put them shits back, dog.
Put them back.
But I got something for you, my guy. Here you go.
New Balances.
I know, my nigga. These shits is fucking fresh. You'll be able to hit the dance floor and cut the rug up. Something like this, my guy. Peep this shit. You're gonna be out there doing this shit right here, my guy. Let's go.
Shake that butt.
You feel me? Get that shit a
try. Baby, get down, gonna shake that.
Look at that. You got that shit.
I got you out there. Are you kidding me, bro? That's how he learned how to dance. He did three steps. He took three steps and he said, I did it? You buggin'.
See?
I certainly did.
It was easy with my...
What are those?
What happened to my dancing shoes?
Nah, some real shit, my G. I needed them shits back.
He yoinked the shoes back. He said, you think I was gonna let you keep these shoes? Nah, them shits had glitter on them.
I'm weaker. I'm stupider. I'm an idiot. I'm a fucking idiot.
This guy's a clown, dude. I'm a fucking idiot.
This video is sponsored by Raycon.
Oh, hell no, Noel. You said there was a, you said seemed relevant regarding the woke controversy around Persona 4 recently. It's also a good watch. Don't tell me there is a woke controversy about Persona 4.
Stay tuned to the end of the video to find out how you can save 15% on your purchase.
What happened?
A window into another world. Maybe it's like our world, maybe it isn't. Perhaps it's a distraction, perhaps it's a reminder, perhaps it's both. I don't necessarily aim to transcend our reality. I just need a break from it. Swinging through the city streets, gliding across the open air, walking along the ramparts, corpse by corpse, they are fantasies. Fantasies with many relatable elements, but fantasies all the same. I don't need to confront anything about my life when I play them. I can just sit back, relax, and disconnect. But not every game affords me that same luxury. Persona 4 Golden released on PC last year. It was a pleasant surprise amidst a sea of anxiety and isolation. Persona 4 is a game I played back during high school. I used it as an escape. My life wasn't bad or anything, but, you know, I was a teenager. I was still figuring things out. It was an awkward time. And Persona 4 was immensely relatable. The town I grew up in was nothing special.
Yes, I agree. Persona 4, when I played it at the time that I played it, it was very, very relatable. And that's why I feel like Persona 4 100% was the game that got me into to the Persona series heavy.
Pretty bog standard. My friends and I frequented a local pizza joint after school. Sometimes we went to the mall or just walked around the neighborhood, but there really wasn't much to do besides talk or play video games. And that's what made this game so appealing to me. Persona 4 was an exciting mirror image of our town. A group of school kids get wrapped up in a murder mystery and use their superpowers to save people from a TV dimension. Why can't my friends and I be wrapped up in something that exciting? I molded myself onto the protagonist and started considering Inaba somewhat of a second home. Yosuke, Chie, Yukiko, Kanji, Risei, Naoto, Teddy, Nanako, Dojima, they weren't real, but the time I spent with them felt real. I got to go on those adventures with them.
But yes. Yes. Right there, that sentence that he said, where he's like, I spent time with all these characters, and they felt real. That's how I felt.
Dojima, they weren't real, but the time I spent with them felt real. I got to go on those adventures with them, bum around Inaba with them, work through insecurities with them. That second home has never left my mind. I have never stopped listening to the music. I have never stopped reminiscing over its moments. Persona 4 will always be floating around in my brain somewhere. It left a permanent imprint on my soul. So to boot up that fresh save again for the first time in years, I expected it to serve a similar function. That it would allow me to jump headfirst into a cheery, joyous adventure with my best pals. That it would give me a momentary reprieve from my depressing mental state. Yet, diving into that June-esque television, keeping up with friends after school, working through those issues, it felt more like a memento, a bittersweet reminder of better days.
Persona, is that what the point of this video is? Persona reminds me of better days. I ain't gonna watch this video just because I feel like it's just him. I feel like this is a video of him ranting on how much better it was back in the day compared to how it is now. Because, I mean, realistically speaking, now it is like we are in a timeline of people are just pussies. We are in like the biggest time frame of like a generational culture shock of people just being bitches and wanting things catered towards them, or they're just gonna cry the whole fucking time. And I like me without even watching this video, I'm probably just gonna agree with everything that he says. Because back in the day, it was way better, you know? We are in different eras now. Wait, you said the wait is finally over, the first episode of Mob Psycho 1, really? It's going down tomorrow, y'all? Really? Yo! When was this posted? Oh, this was posted at 7:30. Yo, we should watch Mob Psycho together and say, fuck it, dude. We should watch Mob Psycho together. Fuck it, dude. I just want to see Reagan the whole time, and I want to see Dimple. I want to see Dimple. Kageyama! He's like, Mob, you shouldn't do that. Everybody will be looking at you weird.
But I don't want to be looked at weird. I just want to go see my brother.
Mob, get some backbone in ya! These dudes are wildin'! Yo, Subway Surfers in real life. Yo, this the most at 40th Street, Lowry, 40th Street. I don't know what train that is, bro. But you saw how fast that train was moving, though? You know, one small misstep and they're dead. One misstep and they're gonna fucking die, dude. Because first of all, that shit is outside. If they fall over, they either gonna fall into the street, which is like 50 feet plus, Or if they land on the tracks, there is a third rail that has like hundreds of volts of live electricity on that bitch. If they fall on the tracks and touch that one shit, they're fucking dead. These guys are, yo, they bugging. That train is going fast as fuck too. I don't know what's going on. And then you know what's the most annoying thing? Is that if something happens to them and they die, the first thing you're going to see is their fucking parents in the news talking about, oh, I don't know what happened. My son was a good child. He never got into trouble. He got straight A's in school and never cut. Get the fuck out of here, bro. Shut your ass up, man. Like I feel no sympathy, bro. Like, whoa! Grimace butt plug? That's a fat ass butt plug, my God. Why do you need your butthole spread open like that? Okay, there is currently a serial killer making his way around Stockton, California. He has not been caught. This person is killing men between the ages of 35 and 55 and has already killed 5. Pass it on. Be safe out there. Monka S. Be careful, California peeps. Yo, anybody in California, be safe. Be safe in Cali. Overwatch 2 got that many haters. Unfortunately, we are experiencing a mass DDoS attack on our servers. Teams are working hard to mitigate, manage. This caused a lot of /connection issues. Hey, man, it is what it is. And with this video popping up, this is how I end. Thank you guys for coming out to the stream. I got to wake up early and go to work tomorrow, unfortunately. Shout out to my little buddy that I have here. Hopefully next time we stream, I could see if I could try to get the other toys because I feel like it's bullshit. I did not want this one and they gave me this one. I have to get the other ones. I'm going to try to tell my sisters that if they order stuff from McDonald's to try to get the Happy Meal because I want to get the rest of the other toys. But, yeah. Thank you, chat. Thank you. You said don't play it? Oh, dude, I have this song stuck in my head. Now I'm taking heat in the classroom. Pro well, I need some donuts in the bathroom. I gotta somehow put it here on this thing. Is it Google Chrome?
Short stream, shortest streamer,
shortest dick. I already know, man. I already know what the fuck you're gonna say, you bitch. I already know what the fuck you're gonna say, you bitch. I beat you to it. Short stream, shortest streamer, shortest dick. Okay. Thank you, guys. Where can I find you? Do I remind you of the dreams we shared? Yo, there's mad people in here. 168. Thank you to all the viewers that are here. All the new viewers, don't forget to follow. 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 Also. Follow me on Twitter. We loot that shit. Follow. All right, we out. Who the hell we're going to raid or host? I'm taking heat in the classroom. Bro, well, I eat some donuts in the bathroom. Yo, that's crazy. We can't host no more. Friend, herself, a boyfriend. She going out for barbecue on the weekend. You see all of the smiles and they pics online. Well, all the boys, they're making me cry. Oh, my prince charming me. Where can I find you? How do I remind you of the dream we share? But dreams are just for dreamers. Silly hearts is immersed. I've got to break the chains.
Dick small.
All right, you guys are gonna bother Fidel because he's playing Fortnite. Oh shit. You said play Iris's song? Oh my god. Oh, motherfucker, stop donating. I'm ending the stream. Y'all throwing like these sound alert bits with the
There you go.
Oh my god, stop with the bitch. See the falling got its swift wings, the rainbow set through the night sky to embrace you. We're just gonna keep looping it. Stop! It's the remix. It's the remix.